can't take that little ass and his disappearing acts anymore. Sometimes I just want to... What is that?
Great! Oh!
You scared the life out of me, Mrs. Fern. You shouldn't sneak up on someone like that. I could have heart failure.
If you don't stop talking to yourself, someone is likely to mistake you for one of Dr. Quincy's patients.
Nonsense. I tell you, Mrs. Fern, someone's over there at Carfax Castle.
Nonsense. Place has been deserted for years.
I saw a candle moving by that window.
Imagination.
Imagination?
Yes.
Once, maybe not three times.
Grim, have you been drinking?
Oh, certainly not. I never touch spirits.
If there's anyone over at Carfax Castle, it's probably children from the village. Up to no good.
You know as well as I do, Mrs. Fernley, the children from the village give that castle and this sanitarium a wide berth.
Go along. Tend to your duties. Dr. Quincy was upset when he discovered Renfield had escaped from his room. Again.
Oh, I don't know how he does it. I lock him in and he gets out. Do you know what he asked me to get him?
I'm only the housekeeper here. I have no interest in patients. Apart from their comfort.
He asked me to get him a nice, fat spider.
That's enough. Go along.
Oh, fine. Nice little castle. Lunatics asking me for spiders.
What on earth is the matter with Grim?
Her work's getting to her, I'm afraid.
Well, I hope she's not thinking of resigning. Help is not easy to come by. My brother says she's rather good with Renfield.
Renfield leads her a merry chase.
Oh, Mrs. Fern, Arthur has arrived. Would you prepare a room for him in the West Wing?
Yes, ma'am. How's Miss Lucy?
Oh, we can't seem to find anything wrong with her. Anything definite. Poor thing has no energy. She's so tired and listless. Sleeps most of the day.
It's probably a bug of some sort or other. I imagine she'll be back on.
My brother is quite worried.
Oh,
we'll have to postpone the wedding date. I had to cancel her appointment with a photographer in London. He was quite put out.
Oh, there you are. Any news of Arthur?
His car was turning in at the gate when I came downstairs. Amina has gone to meet him.
Yes, good.
Dr. Quincy.
Mrs. Fern.
Will you be wanting anything, Mrs. West?
If I want anything, I will bring.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you seen Grim, Mrs. Fern?
He was here just now, Dr. Quincy.
Well, if you see her again, tell her I wish to speak with her. This escape business with Renfield has me concerned.
I'll attend to it at once, Dr. Quincy.
Oh, I have so few patients in residence at the moment.
Are you going to write a book about him?
Who?
About your Renfield?
Oh, perhaps. His case is most unique.
Huh.
You know, he hears voices. Elizabeth.
Please, spare me the clinical report. The sanitarium aspect of our family estate I leave entirely to you. I'm just so worried about Lucy. You don't think it's anything terribly serious, do you?
Let's see how she's feeling in the morning.
Arthur, you'll do wonders for Lucy.
Well, Arthur, delighted you're here, my boy.
Pleased to see you again, Dr. Quincy.
You must be tired after your drive from London.
Not in the least, Mrs. West. How are you?
Very well, thank you.
And how is Lucy?
There's nothing to worry about.
That's not the impression I got when I called yesterday.
Lucy was close to being in a coma.
Coma?
We thought it best to call you. Sit down.
Glad you did.
The wedding plans will have to be delayed.
It's Lucy's health that I'm concerned about. Are you sure that there's no cause for alarm? Oh.
At the moment, it would appear she is suffering from some form of anemia. There's a deficiency in her red blood cells. Quite a mystery, because it came on so sudden.
Oh.
Don't you worry, my boy. I'll have her back to her old self in no time.
That's good to hear. I'll go up and see her.
No, let her rest. I'll see her in the morning.
Of course, if you think it's best. Have we heard from Jonathan?
Oh, dear.
Did I say something wrong?
I'm afraid my poor husband has suffered a misfortune.
There, dear. He'll be home soon, under the best of care.
He's been in Europe on business, somewhere in the mountains of Transylvania.
Yes, a remote region in Romania.
I received one letter from him. He was going to see a nobleman who wanted to buy property here in England. After that letter, I heard nothing.
You mean he disappeared?
I was frantic. No word from him. My letters went unanswered. Then this. It came from a doctor in Budapest. Dear Mrs. Harker, I write at the request of your husband, who is not yet strong enough to do so himself. He has been under my care, suffering from brain fever.
Brain fever?
Your husband has had some fearful shock. In his delirium, his ravings were dreadful. Words such as wolves,
blood,
vampires, and I cannot say what else.
We would have written earlier, but knew nothing of his origin. He came by train from Transylvania. The conductor reports that he rushed into the station, shouting for a ticket to England. Seeing his agitated and they brought him to my hospital. Be assured your husband is well cared for. No doubt he will be ready to travel in a few weeks.
Extraordinary. I don't know what to say.
I contacted the doctor in Budapest. Dr. Bartok, excellent man. He made all the arrangements.
For keeping Jonathan in Budapest?
No, for returning him here, to my care.
Whatever could have happened in those mountains?
I don't know. I'm so grateful to you, Dr. Quincy. I think I would have gone to pieces without your support. Jonathan, now Lucy, it's like a curse.
A temporary setback to our mutual good fortune. Nothing more. The important thing is that Lucy is under my care, and Jonathan soon will be.
Jonathan will be here tomorrow.
That is good news.
Dr. Bartok is sending a nurse along. Jonathan's too ill to travel by himself.
Oh, good gracious! What's that?
Sounds like a wolf.
There are no wolves in England.
More than likely, some wild dog.
Quite so. Oh, still. I wish we hadn't heard it.
Why do you say that?
Any unusual sounds in the vicinity have a tendency to make my brother's guests a bit restless.
It's Brenfield who becomes agitated, Elizabeth.
Only a wild dog, I tell you. Probably foraging for food.
He won't find much if he's hunting the grounds of Carfax Castle. Place is barren of everything but thorn bushes and weeds.
Right.
It's Lucy!
So much
Lucy!
Flora! Flora, I gave you strict instructions that Miss Lucy was to remain in her room.
Uncle, don't scold me, Flora, and don't scold me. I am better. Besides, I didn't want to greet my Arthur, looking pale and wan, in a sick
bed. Sit down, Arthur,
seen
over there.
You in the morning.
Seems I don't have much choice.
Beg your pardon, Dr. Quincy. It's Grim. She says you'd better come along. Renfield is acting up.
Bloody hell.
I think some soup and a cup of hot tea would do wonders.
I'm not hungry.
Doctor's orders. No need, I'll tend to it.
I can see where I'm going to have my hands full with you. I insist on your good health.
Oh, Arthur, you're better than all the medicine my uncle has in his cabinet.
Oh, come along, Flora. We'll give them a few moments together.
Yes, ma'am. You see how they treat me, as if I were a child.
We're all concerned about you. Are you sure you're feeling better?
I am. It's just I've been so weak. At night, I fall into a deep sleep. But when I awake in the morning, it's as if I haven't slept at all. I'm exhausted. Are you awfully disappointed about postponing the wedding?
I'm disappointed about your condition.
I'll be stronger now that you're here, I promise it. How long are you staying?
For as long as you need me.
Dr. Quincy wonders if he might have a word with you in private, Mr. Homewood.
I don't want to leave Miss Lucy.
I'll stay with her.
Go along, the both of you. Oh, here's Flora. I won't be alone now.
I won't be long.
You'll be warm enough.
Too warm. Leave the blanket. I may not need it.
You don't want to catch a chill.
You're being ridiculous, Flora. It's stifling in here. I can hardly breathe. Open the garden doors.
I don't think your uncle would approve.
Open the doors, I said!
Yes, miss.
Dear. That's better. I can breathe again. I think I can sleep now. Tell Mina I'll take the soup later.
I'll sit here.
No, there's no need.
Are you comfortable, miss?
Yes.
Flora! Flora!
Did you hear that, Flora?
Hear what, miss?
Miss Fern was calling for you down the hall.
I'll only be a moment. Specialist. Miss Lucy hasn't been herself at all, and I don't mean being weak and sleepy.
What do you mean then?
You know how kind she is, and gentle.
Indeed I do. A lovely young woman.
Every once in a while, she flashes angry, and her voice becomes harsh, almost cruel. Sometimes I have to turn around and look at her. I'm not certain it is Miss Lucy who is speaking.
When people aren't feeling well, they have a tendency to be irritable.
Maybe.
Yes.
Still, I wish Dr. Quincy would call in that specialist.
Quite a hike back from the village. Everybody's talking.
What about?
The maritime inquiry. You know, that ship that came into harbor last week. Three of the men died on the voyage.
Died? From what?
Anybody's guess. Seems the crew had an eerie feeling that someone or something was a stowaway.
What do you mean, something?
I'm only repeating what my brother told me. Two of the sailors simply disappeared, and one was heard crying out before he was lost for good. And one of the sailors swears he saw a tall, thin man walking the deck. A ghost, he said.
Looks to me as though Dr. Quincy will be having a few more guests.
The truly interesting part is about the cargo.
What's about the cargo?
Four coffins.
Coffins? You said coffins?
I did. When the harbor authority pried the cover off one of the coffins, what do you think they
found? Nothing, I hope.
Filled almost to the top with some foul-smelling earth.
Earth?
Fancy shipping dirt halfway across the continent.
Who would do such a thing?
Our neighbor.
Neighbor?
The consignment was addressed to Carfax Castle. Seems it's been sold to some foreign gentleman from Transylvania.
Grimm said he saw lights at the place. Surely the new owner hasn't already taken up residence.
I wouldn't know a thing about that. I must be about my duties. I'll be in Dr. Quincy's study.
Dr. Quincy promised me a spider.
A spider? That's disgusting. I'll get rid of it.
Now, Mr. Renfield, you know you're not allowed in this part of the house. What are you up to?
Mine.
What are you doing?
Oh, mine.
I'm going to get Dr. Quincy.
What do I care what you do? Go away. Leave me alone. I have important plans.
What? Again? How do you do it, Renfield? You're a regular...
You're not going to take it away from me.
What?
She's caught another spider.
He's mine, I tell you.
Let's have that spot. That is a disgusting habit you have with them insects.
What's a disturbance?
Mr. Renfield.
Grim... You've got to keep a better watch on him.
I try my best, Dr. Quincy, but Renfield's in and out like one of them.
Excuse me, Dr.
Flies, he fancies.
What do I care about flies? I'm through with flies. I want spiders. Nice, fat spiders.
Renfield, why do you wish for spiders?
Spiders are stronger than flies.
I'm crazy before, but Renfield hasn't beat by a mile.
If you only knew... What's going on?
What do you mean by that, Renfield?
Ask Miss Lucy.
Why should I ask?
Or maybe Elizabeth.
Why should I ask my niece anything, as far as you're concerned?
Give me a spider and I'll tell.
Take him back to his room, stay with him. I'll send Nurse Cassidy with a sedative.
I don't want a sedative! I want a spider! Did you hear the wolves? If you only knew!
Curious case.
Przepraszam, ty jesteś Dr. Quincy?
I am.
Ja jestem pani Ania od Dr. Bartok Spital.
Oh, yes.
Budapest.
Oh, delighted you're here. Where is Mr. Harker?
Mrs. Harker.
No, where is Mr. Harker?
Mrs. Harker, Mr. Harker.
Loving reunions can do as much as medicine in these cases.
Tak. Ja mam jego dokumenty tutaj. Dokumenty?
Oh, yes. I shall study these with great interest. I appreciate Dr. Bartok's concern.
English.
Oh, yes. So, how is Jonathan?
On się zrobił troszkę lepszy, ale on jest...
Parlez-vous français?
No.
Obla espanol?
No.
Gone off, actually. Well, I would appreciate your staying here on this case for 1 week. 1 week?
Oh, ja nie planuję wrócić do Romanii as pierwszego month.
Mm-hmm. Splendid. I'll have many questions.
Tak.
Well, I'm confident she'll be comfortable here.
You're
home, dear. You're worried. Oh, Jonathan, how wonderful to see you.
It's good of you to want me here, Dr. Quincy.
Rest is what you need, Jonathan. You'll get it here. Sit down.
You rang, Dr. Quincy?
Oh, yes, this is Miss Anya from Budapest. She'll be spending some time with us. Show her to a room, see that she's made comfortable.
If you'll follow me, miss.
Jak chcesz coś, to tylko mi zadzwoń, Dr. Quincy.
I shall.
She's been a tower of strength.
Whatever happened in Romania, you must put it out of your mind.
Oh, no, I advise against that. Delusions locked up tight have a tendency to fester. Jonathan, I'd like to hear what happened on your business trip.
Is that wise?
Mina, you must leave these matters to me. Here, with friends and wife, Jonathan should feel relaxed and safe. Please, Mina, sit down.
I don't like to recall that trip.
Jonathan, I insist.
I'll try. I want to arrange the sale of Carfax Castle to a nobleman, a Count Dracula. The people who lived in the vicinity of his ancient castle were terrified of the name. They said he and his wife were vampires.
Vampires? Superstition.
I put them down as being little more than ignorant peasants.
Vampires. Vampires. You saw this, Count?
His carriage met me.
Carriage?
That part of the world is like a page from history. The roads were little more than rutted paths. Ooh, he terrified me from the moment I saw him. At first, everything seemed routine. I never saw him in the daytime. And then it happened.
It? Go on.
I was shaving. I cut myself as he came into the room. The sight of blood turned him into something hideous.
Oh.
His lips rolled back. His teeth. His teeth were like bags! I can't go on! No, I won't go on! No, I can't!
Oh, insane!
No, I was his prisoner! I have dreams!
Jonathan, you spoke of dreams.
Must this continue?
Yes, Mina. Jonathan, your dream.
One reoccurring dream. I see, standing in the moonlight, three young women, all with masses of lovely hair, all with pointed white teeth and dark, dark red lips. They whisper together, whispers that could never come through human lips.
Oh, Jonathan? Jonathan!
Jonathan?
What's happened to him? Oh my God.
A deep sleep. Not uncommon in such cases.
I don't understand.
A temporary state of blocking recall. His mind simply refuses to accept the validity of what he's saying. Hence, he blocks it out. My job will be to remove these blocks.
You'd better come along, Doctor. I can't do a thing with Renfield. He's beginning to upset the other patients.
Mina, perhaps if you're to find Miss Anya, prepare another sedative for him.
I will only be a moment. Dreaming of other women.
Jonathan.
He is as I remember him.
He is young and strong.
Go on, you are first.
How dare you touch him? Any of you? I have worked for Jonathan Harker. When I am done with him, you shall have him in your power. Until then, he is mine. Do not interfere with my plans. If you do, your life will be a never-ending torment. Be warned, there are bad dreams for those who sleep unwisely.
Did I dream again? Were they here? Dracula! Dr. Quincy, Miss Anya! He's here!
Jonathan,
he's here.
What happened?
I tell you, they're in here! Dracula is wise!
You had a dream.
I was not dreaming! Can't you understand? He's here!
Jonathan.
Count Dracula! We're doomed, Dr. Quincy, all doomed! Dracula's here!
Wouldn't you rather sit in the sun?
Oh, yeah, byłam, talk z twoim brother in Professor Van Helsing.
The professor seems a nice man. Are they still locked in discussion?
Tak.
I hope the professor would see Lucy immediately.
Oh, on chce mieć... That happened.
It's all beyond me. Doctors, professors, nurses, assumptions. And still, Lucy is pale and drained of energy. Huh. I understand the professor is considered something of a marvel in his field. What is his field exactly? The professor, what?
Oh, Professor Van Helsing jest specjalista w rare rzeczy, co atakują mózg.
Well,
And who is this lovely young lady?
Arthur!
Oh, I've taken Lucy to the garden.
Did she feel up to it?
She was terribly weak this morning.
Again?
But I persuaded her to have breakfast.
How was her appetite?
She ate nothing but the steak. Almost wolfed it down. Blood rare.
Oh, well, at least that's something. I'll visit with her.
She's over by the tree.
Thank you. Miss Anya! Miss Anya! Oh, never mind. Lucy?
What of Mr. Harker?
On spell dogs, I can go down to Spania.
Ah, I hate to see him in such a condition.
Seems to be suggesting odd possibilities. Oh, Professor Van Helsing, I would like to introduce you to Arthur, my niece's fiancé. Arthur, this is Professor Van Helsing.
I am greatly disturbed by what I have been hearing.
About Lucy.
The aura of sinister forces that seem to be gathering around here.
Whatever are you talking about?
Jonathan Harker's story. This nobleman, Dracula.
Ah, bajkaz mojego kraju. Bajka żeby nas tracić dzieci. Jak ty się nie uspokoisz, to Dracula ciebie dostanie.
Ah, tak, tak. We have the tale told by the harbor master. A near phantom ship, coffins delivered to the neighboring estates. The wolves have been heard.
Will you see Lucy now?
Directly.
Shall we join her outside in the garden?
That won't be necessary, Arthur. I'm here.
You should stay in the sun. It will do you good. Put color in your face.
The brightness hurts my eyes. I prefer shadows.
Please, if you'd be so kind. I am Professor Van Helsing.
Yes, I've heard so much about you.
And I of you, Miss Lucy. I am very curious.
Please, one moment. She must rest.
Of course. I should wish to speak with your, Renfield.
We can visit his room whenever you're ready.
I would prefer to see him here, in more informal surroundings. It will help to relieve some of his anxiety.
Yes, Miss Anya.
Mukteresh, dikt vorchit mutrak green.
Oh, tak. Jego znajdę.
I am told by your uncle that this weakness came upon you a week ago.
Yes.
That apart from a general feeling of apathy and weakness, you had no complaints.
Except for the dream.
Ah, yes, the dream. Tell me, Miss Lucy, what do you see in your dream?
I dread to worry those I love. Still, I must confess to you and to my uncle and to Arthur, that I have been very troubled.
The dream. Tell me about the dream.
I sleepwalk in the dream. I knew I was dreaming that very first night I rose from my bed. Yet, I didn't quite dream. It all seemed so real. Then, I have a vague memory of something approaching me. Something that spoke in a soft, yet frightening voice. It had red eyes that I was compelled to look into, even though I tried to turn away.
Yes, yes.
I felt as if I were sinking into stagnant water. My soul seemed to leave my body. I felt so lost, so alone and lost.
This dream repeats itself.
Every night, when I fall into a deep sleep, only now.
Only now? What?
That something that approaches me no longer frightens me. I seem to wait anxiously for the sound of its voice. I don't want to think about it anymore.
Does she have to go on?
I have heard enough of the dream. Tell me, Miss Lucy, that scarf around your neck.
Who wanted me, Dr. Quincy?
Yes, bring Renfield here.
He's been quite moody this morning. Quite moody.
Never mind about that. Give him a sedative.
I think I'd like to go back outside now, Arthur. I could sit in the shade of the big tree. It's cool there and dark.
Did you want any more information, Professor Van Helsing?
Later. I think the fresh air and your company would prove beneficial.
Thank you.
you see no connection between your niece's dream and the hallucinations of Jonathan Harker?
I see a strong connection. I'm not certain what it means.
As a colleague, allow me to contradict you. What you mean to say is that your intelligence, your professional training, your very sanity rebels at the thought of vampirism.
Vampirism? You can't be serious.
Precisely. Vampirism.
Lucy is falling under the influence of a vampire. Is that what
Curious.
You mean?
Curious. First Cassidy said he wouldn't take his morning bath.
I don't like water.
Don't mind your manners.
That's enough, Grim.
I know you. I know all about you. I heard the nurses talking. You're a famous professor. Won't do any good you studying me. I'm cured. I'm over my problem.
Delighted to hear that, Mr. Renfield. Be so good as to sit down.
Why not? You're wasting your time, though.
You've lost your appetite for flies and spiders.
Who wants flies and spiders? Puny things. I don't have to tell you anything.
Quite true. Never mind. The important thing is that you no longer have this compulsion.
That's right. He promised me that if I serve him faithfully, one day I'll be as he is.
Who do you speak of?
The Master.
The Master?
I said too much. He warned me about that.
You can trust me. Dr. Quincy and I are your friends.
I don't want friends. I don't need friends. You'll see. You'll all see. Wait until it happens.
Are we in danger from something?
I've said enough.
I step over to the light, Mr. Renfield. I should wish to check your eyes.
No, 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 no.
My questions
no,
seem to be upsetting
no,
you.
No,
Renfield,
no, no,
Renfield,
no,
if you don't do as I say, I shall make arrangements with your family and have you transferred from my sanitarium.
No! I must stay here. I must stay close to Carfax Castle.
Why?
Renfield.
Mr. Renfield? I asked you a question.
Won't do no good, Professor. Not when he goes into one of his little sulks. You come along with me, Renfield.
Carfax Castle would be the adjoining estate.
Yes.
It is also the location that received that strange cargo of boxes or coffins containing soil.
If we're to believe Nurse Cassidy.
It is all a matter of record. Is it not also the same location that Jonathan Harker represented when he journeyed to Transylvania?
Are you suggesting that my neighbor is a vampire?
I am not suggesting it. I am declaring it. Remember, you have brought me here to this house because you, with all your talent as a medical man, could not diagnose your niece's sickness. I tell you, she is the victim of a vampire. Even the behavior of Renfield is symptomatic of a larger evil.
I'm certain everything can be explained rationally, sensibly.
The vampire's strength lies in the fact that so few believe in its existence.
I insist on proof.
Oh,
it is a prerogative of a scientific mind.
I thought you were in your study. I should have gone by way of the garden. I'm taking Miss Lucy, who's sewing.
One moment.
Sir?
You are Miss Lucy's personal maid.
Yes, sir. Flora.
Tell me, Flora, have you noticed any changes in Miss Lucy?
Well,
You may speak freely in front of the professor.
Miss Lucy has been acting funny. I won't deny that. She gets angry at little things. This morning, she threw her hand mirror across the room and smashed it into 100 pieces. It was like she couldn't bear to look at herself. I always thought she was fond of that mirror.
Thank you, Flora. That will be all.
I do hope she'll be well soon.
So do I.
You attach some significance to this mirror?
He will visit the house tonight.
Who?
Who else? Dracula.
I don't know what to believe
you
anymore.
You wanted proof. Tonight you shall have it. Tonight I will prove to you Dracula is one of the undead.
Undead?
Professor Charles.
Nurse Cassidy, I think you better make room for another guest.
Yes, Doctor.
Nurse Cassidy, did you put garlic at my windows?
Yes, Professor Van Helsing said it was just a precaution.
I wish I knew what was happening. I have never seen such goings on. I thought he could diagnose Lucy's condition and set her on the path to good health.
Well, after working in this place for almost a year, I've come to expect anything. However, garlic buds are unusual.
Do sit down, Nurse Cassidy. I'm developing a phobia of being alone.
Some hot tea might calm your nerves.
Sit! I don't want any tea. I want a simple explanation of all this mumbo-jumbo.
The professor believes that your daughter is being victimized by a bat.
A bat?!
Apparently, it somehow manages to get into the house and then bites Miss Lucy.
Is that your idea of humor, Nurse Cassidy?
No, I'm speaking the truth.
A bat! A bat! I have never heard such idiocy. I shall have a talk with my brother. Miss Anya, I demand an explanation. What is all this talk about a bat?
Oh, me a bat, Mrs. Vest. Vampire? Professor Van Helsing, mostly the Miss Lucy, yes, visit od vampire.
Surely you don't believe in human vampires?
Tak.
What next?
What is a human vampire?
Tak it coś, co chce pić kres. On jest bardzo silny. Oh, tak.
Ah! Mrs. West! Mrs. West!
Bats! Vampires! I think I'd better go to my room and lie down. Charles!
You come along with me!
No, Dore.
Ja myślę, że straciłam jego siostrę.
Tu są swe motory sidła, motory duchy widzia.
Tak.
Something wrong?
She was explaining vampires to your sister. She didn't take it very well.
Should have anticipated her reaction. I don't suppose she's in danger.
You're all in danger, Dr. Quincy. However, I believe that Dracula's interest and attention focuses solely on Miss Lucy for the moment.
We're here, Professor Van Helsing.
As you requested.
Excellent, we can proceed.
Yeah, man, talk.
Mr. Harker.
Are you serious, Professor Van Helsing, about this Dracula thing? What makes you think Dracula will come to this house?
Miss Lucy's dream. The creature visits every night. Only tonight, when he discovers precautions have been taken against him, he will know he has met his match.
What are we to do?
I must discover his reason for being here in England. Once I have determined that, I will know my course of action.
Beg your pardon, Dr. Quincy?
What is it, Mrs. Fern?
It's a gentleman, sir, come to pay his compliments. Your neighbor, he says, a foreign-looking gentleman, gave me quite a start, he did, standing in the moonlight at the door.
His name?
Count Dracula.
Show him in. He has come to laugh at us. We must be on our guard. He'll be watching us as much as we'll be watching him. We must not let him know we are afraid.
Count Dracula.
I trust my arriving unannounced will not be an inconvenience. I am Dracula. Count Dracula.
Won't you come in? This is a dear friend of mine, Mrs. Harker.
Delighted.
My niece's fiancé, Arthur Holmwood.
Charmed.
And hiding over here is Professor Van Helsing.
I know the name.
I never thought I would come face to face with a Transylvanian nobleman.
Now you know better.
Oh, I haven't introduced
you. You are Dr. Quincy, the noted psychiatrist.
I'm flattered that you know my name.
When I rented the castle, I took the trouble to inquire about my neighbors.
Won't you sit down, Count?
You are so kind. Harker, Harker, I seem to know that name,
How do
too.
You find England?
So unlike my homeland in the Carpathian Mountains.
Yours is an old name, a proud name.
We of the House of Dracula have a right to be proud of our past. For in our veins flows the blood of many brave nations who fought as the lions fight for lordship.
That was many centuries ago, when the Dracula name was in its glory.
Time means nothing to a Dracula.
Surely you can't be comfortable at Carfax Castle.
I find the place restful.
Oh. Do you have any plans for restoration?
None.
Uh-oh. What appeals to you about the place?
Its brooding quality, its isolation. I require solitude. I am particularly fond of its overgrown cemetery. It lends a certain charm.
But the wolves, they appear to be on the grounds of the castle.
Oh, 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 my dear Mrs. Harker, everyone knows there are no wolves in England.
What will you do here in England?
Rejuvenate myself. I grew weak in my mountains. The land has become barren. Nothing grows but twisted trees. The people are old. The blood in their veins is weak as water. The young have left. The climate is bad.
Mrs. Harker?
I hope you'll excuse me, Count. Yes, so I am not well. I have a fierce headache.
Perhaps you should go with her, gentlemen.
Yes, perhaps you're right.
The room has emptied rather quickly.
You said you knew my name.
I have read much of your work. Even in Transylvania, you are well known, at least to me.
I find that flattering. But my work deals mainly with the outer regions of the mind as they affect the body. I have a special interest in vampirism.
I know.
I have something here that will interest a man of your sensibility. From Venice. Very old.
I am fond of antiquities.
The back was encrusted with gold by no less an artist than Cellini himself.
What is it?
A mirror. How remarkable, Count Dracula. You cast no reflection in the glass.
So you know what I am.
I do.
Beware! It is unwise to know too much about Dracula.
I will destroy you, and with you your evil.
It is you who have barred me from Miss Lucy's room. Take care. She is to be the bride of Dracula.
Is that your grand scheme in coming to England?
It will amuse me to tell you. I have wasted as much as I dare of my homeland. I need a place where people will laugh. At the ideal of a vampire. A new land where we can breathe again and grow strong. A new land where we can breathe again and grow strong.
We are Dracula. We follow. We obey.
And this is what you would have Miss Lucy become.
You know nothing of my world.
I know I will conquer.
Unhealthy. So you and the others would try your wits against mine. You would frustrate me. In my design, you shall be sorry. Each one in this house. Tonight, I will claim you as I claimed Lucy West. Tonight, when the clock strikes midnight, all the evil things in the world will have full sway. Time is on my side, and I shall be back.
I saw it. Quite a hair-raising experience.
You wanted proof. Now you have it.
But what do we do now?
We must prepare for the coming battle.
Nurse Cassidy!
Are my guests
calming
down? I've had enough of this game of house. Back and go! I've made up my mind.
What was that?
Oh! I said, I think I should take that flat in London. Oh,
this is hardly the time to discuss that.
And I think Lucy should come with me.
Don't be absurd. We could talk about this in the morning. Why aren't you in your room?
Oh, it's horrid in there. Your vampire hunter has bushes at the door, garlic at the windows. How is anyone to sleep in such an atmosphere?
Sleep is not the issue, Mrs. West. Survival is.
I suppose you think I might be attacked by your human...
We are all in danger, Mrs. West.
I'm afraid we are. You'd better return to your room.
Do not open your door for anyone, not even me. Do not leave your room until the sun comes up. Your life may depend on it.
I will not be a person in my own.
Poor thing. This is all beyond her. There's one consolation. No sign of Dracula.
Ah, but there is.
There's someone outside.
We must conceal ourselves.
Enter, man. Enter. I will do everything you say. I will obey. I am here to do your bidding. I have been waiting for you. I knew you would not fail me. Now you will reward me. I await your commands, and you will not pass me by. You will share with me. You will let me become one with the night. Oh, lovely winged creature. Oh, lovely bat. I obey. I obey.
Elizabeth! Elizabeth!
It has begun. Dracula is in the house. We must discover where.
But how can we, when he has the power to change himself into a winged rodent? Or become invisible?
We have the bedroom safe against its entry. We each carry a small cross for protection. Against the cross, he is helpless. First to Miss Lucy.
First to Elizabeth.
Of course.
Redfield's gonna get the sedative of his life.
We must be ready.
When Dracula calls,
time is near.
Redfield! Redfield, where are you?
Oh, beg your pardon, ladies.
Ladies, let's go.
She is young, healthy, strong.
I beg your pardon.
Are you a nurse?
Yes.
Yes, yes, my children. I hear all is well. Professor Van Helsing, to think bulbs of garlic and clusters of wolfbane could defeat me. I have the power to draw those I want close to me whenever I desire. Miss Anya, I trust, has just awoken from a deep slumber.
Haven't you done enough to me?
Even I, in this strange land, have limitations. I will need someone to move about in the daytime. Someone who will look after my affairs.
I will never help you!
You cannot resist.
I can!
Well.
Where could you?
I must! Mina!
You see, resistance is useless.
I will never help you!
You cannot resist my will!
I can't. You. I want nothing from you. I will not serve you!
You see? It's absolutely useless.
Oh my God, Jonathan!
Jonathan!
Mr. Harrington!
How could this happen? Miss Anya, what managed to keep her picture?
We found him here?
Dracula said he'd have need of my services. Since he can't move about in the daylight, I am to be useful. If you could have only seen his eyes. I couldn't look away.
The fiend is even more powerful than I imagined.
What will we do now?
We must destroy him.
How will we destroy him?
We must find his resting place.
Oh, the coffin!
We must destroy them. What set is done, the vampire is finished, for he must return to his native soil an hour before dawn. He has no power from sunrise to sunset.
I believe I could lead you to his hiding place. I drew up the documents. He was particularly anxious about the ruined chapel. Let's go, I'll show you.
Should we go with...
Can object as long as I'm with you.
I can't stay in my room another moment. I'll suffocate.
I must admit, the smell is overpowering.
Like living in a locked closet or a hothouse of tropical plants.
You're sure you're up to it, being up and about. Mustn't overdo. They've been gone for what seems like ages.
I hope they've come to no harm.
Arthur,
here. Sit beside me. I only feel safe when you're close.
You've nothing to fear.
You must be exhausted.
A little.
Rest.
I can't.
I'll help you.
Listen to the sound of my voice.
So soothing.
Try to sleep. Put all thoughts from your mind. Drift. Feel yourself sinking into a stagnant pool of water.
No, Miss Lucy, I forbid
it. Take it away. Freeze my eyes.
Arthur.
I arrived in time. We must save her before she is lost.
Did you do it? Did you destroy the coffins?
All but one.
We only found three of the coffins.
Lucy.
Where is Miss Lucy?
We must find Miss Lucy.
I'll check in the garden.
Mr. Hobo, check outside.
Yes.
I will check the sanitarium.
Lucy.
Mr. Harker,
Lucy.
Bring me in here.
Here?
You will pay for what you have done!
Let me be! Leave me in peace!
I warned you!
Let me be, I say!
You have dared to lead them to my secret chapel. You have helped them destroy the coffins of my wife.
We'll find your coffin in time and destroy you!
Never!
Too late, Count Dracula.
You shall be the first to die.
You were unwise in coming here.
I claim Miss Lucy as my bride.
Never!
She too will be saved.
You know so little. Come, I command, by my side, throughout eternity, bride of the vampire.
Night unto night, I will be with you.
Professor Van Helsing, do something!
He can do nothing. His fate is sealed.
No, Dracula, your fate is sealed. In coming here, you have spent valuable time.
Look, the dawn.
You'll never make it back to Carveret's castle in time!
I will! I must!
Look! Lucy!
The victory is ours!
Lucy!
I feel so odd. What am I doing down here?
Lucy, you're safe now.
I feel as if I'm returning from some dark place. I had that terrible dream again. Oh, I hope I don't faint.
You'll be fine, I promise it.
I hoped his anger would be so fierce that he would return here, forgetting the danger of time in his rage.
Has it truly ended?
We have survived the curse of Dracula.
Just a moment, ladies and gentlemen. Just a word before you go. We hope that the memories of Dracula and Renfield will not give you bad dreams. So just a word of reassurance. When you go home tonight, and the lights have been turned down, and you are afraid to look behind the curtain, you fear to see the face of a man looking back at you through the window, why, just pull yourself together, and remember that, after all, there are such things.
this book of doom. No one else will be tempted down my path of terror. Then I will rest in my grave, for I am now dead. The demon has survived and is amongst you. Many months ago began my dreadful tale of terror. The demon has survived to gnaw upon my bleaching bones. My spirit is left, fueled by the passion of our mutual hate. I am in a frozen netherworld, uninhabited by man, where I share only his loneliness, his desperation, his isolation. Oh, it is bitter cold. Many months ago began my dreadful tale of terror. The demon I am responsible for. Everything he has done, I am responsible for, remains alive. I am for everlasting cursed. I cannot rest until he is destroyed. He is my creation, and I am chained with him, locked in the flames of hell, forever. Many months ago began my dreadful tale of terror. Ah!
To damage him.
Yes, doctor.
We have to be careful because
he's an excellent specimen.
Yes, 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 yes. How did he die?
Oh, well, hanged by the neck.
Till death. This morning.
I have no use for one with a broken neck. I have told you that before. You're wasting my time, damn you.
Wait, come back here.
This one's different because His tongue is sticking out, and
his eyes bulging out. See for yourself, doctor.
So, is he not a good one?
100 francs?
It seems the hangman's knot was improperly placed.
100 francs?
Certainly not. The usual fee, as we agreed upon.
But this one is so fresh, so young, and so healthy.
Yes, yeah. Well, he was,
but he still is!
A single franc more! You are hardly in a position to barter. Somebody may come by at any minute. I will be beyond reproach, having just caught you in the act. I will leave you the money in the same place.
Oh, I have to return. The magistrate is visiting.
I cannot be seen here.
Hello?
Somebody is coming.
Well, what's up for the body?
After 9, when the magistrate and his wife have left.
Hello?
I mustn't be seen.
Oh, quick, we must
Hello be over there! Oh. Can you help me?
Oh. Hello? Hello? Is anybody there?
Ah! Oh my god!
What can I do for you?
My driver is lost. Darkness came upon us so quickly. I am trying to find my way to the house of Dr. Frankenstein.
Oh, it's over there!
Oh my god!
The bridge, yes.
How many of you are down there?
1, 2, 3!
What are you doing?
Oh, digging!
Digging for gold!
Yes, for Frank.
For Frank's wrong, Frank!
Well, are you a religious person?
No.
Well, perhaps I'd like to say something for
you. I don't think so. Good night.
Wait, the castle's that way.
Could have been the magistrate.
Let's get out of here.
Hurry, hurry.
1, 2, 3!
Anything on time.
Boris, where are you going?
I hope the doctor reaches the house before the storm.
Well, if you ask me,
I didn't ask you.
Why don't you like this with me, Boris? I remember when we used to
Morticia, we're not going to talk about that again. I would appreciate you finishing setting the table, then check with the cook to make sure everything is all right. The magistrate and his wife should be here presently.
Boris,
to the cook!
I'm always on my cloak.
Yes, doctor.
I'm glad to see you missed the storm, doctor.
Thank you, Boris.
Please notify me immediately if the barometer falls rapidly.
Immediately, Doctor.
Is all prepared for the von Nudorks?
Just as you requested. The Nudorks should be here at any moment.
Very good. Oh, Boris, before you leave, there will be a special delivery later this evening. Please tell Shigor to wait by the garden door and then have the equipment transported directly to my laboratory.
As you wish, Doctor.
Ah, tonight. Tonight, all the waiting will be over. My experiment is about to become reality, and I will have created, truly created. Ah, the storm is getting closer. Marvelous! No longer will they laugh at my theories. I will have created, recreated life, the essence of life.
Doctor, magistrate and his wife have arrived. Should I show them in?
Yes. Take their coats and show them into the waiting room. I will be there presently. Do not bring them here.
Yes, Doctor.
Shigor! Shigor! Shigor!
Yes, Master, you...
Ooh! Shigor, did Boris tell you about the delivery tonight?
Yes, I was to wait at the garden door and then take it to the laboratory.
Once you have completed the preliminaries, you must immediately turn on the generator to 6.
6?
Yes, 6. And then come for me. Touch nothing else. Now, Shigor! Did you have a pleasant drive out? It looks as though there's going to be a storm. Horrible weather. I do not know. Would you like to be seated?
Yes.
Thank you.
After you, Doctor.
Thank you.
Sit down.
Would you like some wine?
No, thank
yes.
you.
Yes.
Red or white?
Red.
If you must, white.
Red.
White.
White.
Red.
White.
Red.
White.
Excuse me.
White.
Afternoon tea will be served.
I was just saying to Walter.
Yes, Hildegard, you were. The children will be fine, and your dear mother is with them.
What do you have against...
Were you present at the hanging this morning?
No, I wasn't.
He was a young man. It seems the young are becoming more violent. I had to hand down the strictest sentence to teach them a lesson not soon to be forgotten, I hope.
I told you, Walter, we should have turned back. The children
will be fine.
But, Walter...
Be fine.
But...
Fine.
Would you please use that door, Boris?
As you wish, Doctor.
Are you expecting another guest?
Not at all.
A telegram, perhaps?
I wasn't expecting one.
No one expects a telegram, Walter. They only bring bad news.
Oh, be quiet. Is it a package, perhaps?
A package, yes. No.
It's awfully late. Perhaps the children...
Hildegard, please.
Excuse me, Doctor. A visitor for you.
Who?
I asked the name, but I was told it is to be a surprise.
A surprise? Tonight? Boris, I hate surprises. Send them away, Boris. Away to another door. I have the magistrate here, Boris. Now, Boris.
As you wish, Doctor.
A surprise? A surprise? Ooh, I love surprises. Who could it be?
Never mind that, Hildegard. Enjoy your tea. I hope you find it flavorful.
Yes, it has a kind of a wild taste to it. Is this...
No, I think it is a preservative our cook uses.
I find it very tasty. Mm.
Excuse me, Doctor. The party at the door insists and will not leave without seeing you.
Very well. Excuse me, Magistrate von Nudork. Frau Hildegard, I will be but a moment.
If you keep going on about the children, this will be the last time
and
I take you anywhere.
Who wants to hear about you hanging people? Certainly not me.
It was different this time.
How?
The knot was in the wrong place, and he choked to death.
So will I.
I wish you would. I was going to ask the doctor her medical
I
opinion.
I am not interested. Silence. Drink your tea.
Fine.
Oh?
This is my old college friend, Dr. Henrietta von Hausen. I haven't seen her since last year. She just came all the way from Geneva. This is our magistrate, Herr von Newdorf.
Pleased to meet you.
Oh.
Walter!
And his charming wife, Hildegard.
Pleased to meet you.
You're just in time for some tea, Henrietta.
No, thank you. I am quite tired.
Oh. Boris, please show Dr. von Hausen to the guest room in the north wing. Make sure she has all she needs. Perhaps you would like Boris to draw you a nice hot bath, Henrietta.
Oh, that would be lovely. Thank you.
Perhaps, when you are rested, you might like to join us?
Certainly.
Good.
I don't think we will be here that long, Dr. Frankenstein. The storm is closing in, and I am concerned about our children. Thunder and lightning really upsets them.
It was a pleasure meeting you. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
You were in college with Dr. von Hausen?
Yes, we were both in biological research at the university. We worked together for 3 years, and then she went on to become a general practitioner.
And you? What is your area of specialty, Doctor? You have been here nearly a year, and we haven't had a chance to become acquainted.
Research.
What? Did you see that? Just now?
What?
Past the window? It looked like two men carrying a body.
What are you talking about? There's nothing there. Hold yourself together, Hildegard.
I tell you, Walter, I know what I saw. Just for an instant. Dr. Frankenstein, did you see it?
Not at all. It was probably the gardener moving my prized aspidistras into the conservatory out of this storm.
Ah, aspidistras are my favorite plants.
Since when?
Do you use them in your research?
Not exactly.
Exactly what kind of research do you do then?
Molecular regeneration and the human aging process.
Ah, you mean that you'll be able to make me young and beautiful again?
Hardly, my dear.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're ugly.
Oh! How could you say such a horrid, horrid thing?
Would you like some more tea? Morticia, look after their cups.
No more tea for us, thank you. It is getting quite late and we do have a distance to go.
Perhaps we could stay longer next time. I would be interested in looking at your laboratory. Reviewing your research, if I may be permitted.
Certainly, you would be most welcome. Boris, the von Newdorks are having to leave a little early. Please send Shigor to the stable for their carriage.
As you wish, Doctor.
May I say what a pleasure it has been. Perhaps we will see you in the village at the next county meeting. The elections are coming up, and a person of letters such as yourself may be considered a worthy candidate.
All politics aside, perhaps afternoon tea at the Manor House next Wednesday.
Perhaps. Boris, please show the magistrate and his wife to their carriage. Good night. Safe journey home.
Good night. I am never taking them anywhere.
God, I thought they would never leave. Ah, the storm. The storm is almost at its height. Shigor, is everything ready? The storm is almost upon us.
I am not yet finished, Doctor.
Why not? You imbecile! I saw the specimen arrive right past the window. What have you been doing?
Look at me! I'm completely soaked! You just sent Boris for me to go to the stable for the carriage! It was pouring down! Oh, I got saturated! How can I prepare things in the laboratory and run errands in the rain at the same time? Oh, I may be stupid, but I cannot be two places at once.
Shigor, shut up! Go to the laboratory and prepare!
Yes, ma'am.
No! 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 Oh, Henrietta, you startled me.
Who was that strange little specimen running out just now?
That was Shigor, my lab assistant, twin sister of the infamous Igor.
Lab assistant? Lab?
What kind of lab?
No salt, really.
What have you been up to since you moved out here?
Nothing in particular.
Don't play strange with me.
Strange?
You aren't still.
What?
Oh, you are! Victoria Frankenstein, are you still playing around with that regeneration theory that drove us crazy at university?
No. You are! I know you are!
Oh, tell me about it.
Oh, I've been dying to share it with someone.
What?
Hetty, I'm on the edge. I've almost got it. You are sworn to secrecy. Swear.
Victoria, it's me, your best friend. The only one who stood by you and your insane theories. All right, I swear.
Then listen. I am about to create the perfect... You'll see.
You can't be serious. Genetic molecular reconstruction?
Yes, sort of. Tonight, if this storm keeps up, I have developed a converter, which by my calculations should provide me with enough electricity for a well-placed bolt of lightning to stimulate the matter into life.
Matter? What matter? What are you using for your prototype?
Would you like to see? It's in the laboratory. Sheeple, is everything ready?
Yes, Master. All is prepared.
Good. Good.
Who is this?
This is my good and trusted friend, Dr. Von Hausen. This is Sheeple, my lab assistant.
Pleased to meet you. After you.
Disgusting.
I'm so hungry. Perhaps if I took a little wine, it would help clear my head. This is good. Red, white, pink. Drink. This is really good.
Sheeple, you have the key to the laboratory.
Oops. I'm coming! No, I'm not!
No, you're not! Sheeple!
So sorry to keep you waiting, Master.
She really is quite interesting. Where did you find her?
From her parents. They could no longer keep up with her. She is reliable, strong, and totally loyal. My secret is safe with her.
What a remarkable laboratory. What do we have over here?
Oh, that is my matter. My matter. My brainchild. My reason for living.
May I take a look?
Not yet. Oh. We have to have all prepared. There, hand me that gauge, please.
This?
There. Look, the level of electricity in the air is very high.
Oh, Master, is it going to work this time?
I hope so, Sheeple. Be patient.
Victoria, I don't understand. These are human specimens. What are you doing?
Those are for something else. Here, hold this. Careful now.
What do you want me to do, Master?
Over there, Sheeple, by the condenser. Quickly, stand by.
I'm ready, Master.
Oh, my God! Victoria! You're insane! This is a person! What have you done? What have you done? Was a person, and soon will be a better one.
Did you kill him?
Oh, of course not! He was already dead.
Not today. This afternoon. As I was coming here, I came across two men. I thought they were burying, not removing.
Victoria, this is not right. This is illegal. I want no part of this.
Not want to be part of the scientific discovery of this century.
You have gone too far.
Not want to be here at the making of history. To be eternally famous.
No.
Master, the readings. They are climbing quickly. Look.
Well, Henrietta, I don't see you leaving.
Fascinating.
Exactly. You are about to see a new era in the making. Bear with me. To the making of the first perfect man!
What do you mean, perfect man?
I have saved, isolated, and repositioned, relocated
attributes of men into this one fresh, young corpse. There were several physical changes I have had to make. A hand here, a foot there, and so on. But the results, the results! Just think of it. The perfect man, the perfect woman, perfect children.
You are playing with the laws of God and the laws of nature.
Does not nature adapt? Leave it to Mother Nature. And did not God create to his likeness? Which is no longer the case. Look about you. This body was hanged for crimes against man. He shall return the perfect example of all he should have been.
Master, master, the time is upon us. Reading at 97.
Are you going to help?
What do you want me to do?
Stethoscope, breathing, and check for pulse.
Nothing.
Wait!
Nothing.
Shigo!
Inside the hole, my master!
Shigo, the discombobulator, the reading!
Over 100, master!
Open the flaps! Wider! Wider!
I have a pulse, I think!
Shigo, reading!
150 and rising! Rapidly!
Movement! I have movement! The eyelids? A pulse?
What
a
beat?
The heart? What beat?
Nothing.
Wait! A murmur!
Close to 200, master!
I have a beat!
Moving.
2, 3,
you could be on the brink of curing many of our own human imperfections.
Human imperfections?
Yes.
Such a lisping? Human cures?
Yes.
No. That is not what I intended at all. I have within my grasp the creation of the perfect man, free from all those ailments from the very beginning. A man of great strength, who, coupled with my creation of the perfect woman, would produce perfect children.
Victoria, you are insane. Did this experiment not clearly indicate to you that you are going beyond the limits of physical possibilities into a realm of danger that might have the reverse effect?
Nonsense. This experiment clearly indicated to me that my theories are within my grasp. You yourself felt the pulse, heard the heartbeat, witnessed the movement of the eyelid.
But that is merely electrical. Just as one can move the detached leg of a frog.
Yesterday, the leg of a frog. Today, the flicker of life. Tomorrow, under the optimum conditions, the restoration of life.
Doctor, do you want me to get rid of this specimen?
Not at all, Shigor. We can try again later this evening. The storm will be with us for quite some time.
Victoria!
Yes, Shigor, help me with this.
Attach that to there, connect that to there, move that over there.
Careful now.
Victoria, I think I will return to my room for a while. I have a terrible foreboding that you will suffer a great personal misfortune if you persist in this folly.
As you wish. I will have Boris take some herbal tea up to you. It will help settle your nerves.
Thank you.
Quickly, Shigor, pass me the...
Oh, never mind. Here it is.
Good.
good. What reading do we have? Oh. The storm seems to be subsiding. Perhaps maybe I could...
I can pack in an ice for you. It may give us a few more hours.
Yes, yes, that will do. I will quickly go and tell Boris.
Oh, let me see now. Looks all right to me. Now, green to red, red to yellow, yellow to white, and white to blue.
Ow!
Oh, I don't think so. Think so? Oh, I remember. Green to green, red to red, yellow to yellow, and white to white. Got it. Ready? Ready, my beauty? The storm! The storm is upon us!
Doctor! Doctor Frankenstein!
Hurry! Stay right here! Hurry! Where can you go?
If she is dead,
and neither of us were here, and Franz and Lieb could not get in, then who could have? And where is the body we brought in earlier?
Exactly. Where is the body we brought in earlier? Unless... No, it couldn't have. Maybe she will think. Think like you've never thought before. After you redid the connections, but before you came to find me, Shigor, why did you come to find me? What did you want me for?
To tell you of a fresh storm approaching.
That's it then. That's it. The only possible explanation. My findings are true. My discovery is real. I have proven the creature lives. Oh, but what of this tragedy? What has happened in this room? I must find our prototype and make the adjustment before this horrendous act repeats itself on other innocent victims. Shigor, search the house, every nook and cranny. Tell no one.
Shouldn't I get Boris to help us? We should warn Mortissa.
Tell no one. Here, take this syringe. It will take seconds to work. Once you have him sedated, if the coast is clear, bring him back here.
And Dr. Von Helsing?
Leave her to me. I will look after her. Remember, tell no one of what has happened here. Once we have found him, and he is adjusted, you will become the perfect partner.
Morticia?
Boris! What are you doing? You frightened me!
Well, Boris, if you ask me, there's something really strange going on here.
It is not up to us to ask or say anything. We simply have to do our jobs, do as we are told, and what happens within these walls stays within these walls. Do you understand me, Morticia?
Yes, Boris, but this place gives me the creeps. That Shigor is always looking at me. And yesterday, those two scruffy-looking hangabouts almost knocked me over running down the back staircase.
You mean Herr Franz and Herr Lee?
I think that's who they were. It was fairly dark out, and they came out of nowhere and rushed out into the night.
What were they doing here? If you didn't let them in, then it must have been Shigor. I don't think the doctor knows they were here. Either way, it is none of our business, and if you keep poking your nose into it, we are just going to get into trouble. We may even be dismissed.
Have you seen Dr. Von Hausen today? She didn't come down for breakfast.
Morticia, you're poking your nose into other people's business again.
But Boris, I don't know where she is.
Morticia!
And I haven't seen her in a few days.
No, Morticia, that's enough.
Boris, you're always like this. Something's up. I don't know, but Dr. Von Hausen...
Morticia, please, we will not talk about
Boris,
this now.
Boris, may I talk with you, please? Morticia, you may leave us.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor, may I be of assistance?
There are to be no visitors today. I will be in the laboratory and do not, under any circumstances, wish to be disturbed. If you have any concerns, address them to Shigor.
Yes, doctor, they'll be coming to dinner this evening.
Probably not. Remember, no interruptions.
Dr. Von Hausen's room. Did you lock the door?
It must be stuck. We've been having problems with doors sticking due to the humidity.
No, no, it's locked, not stuck. I can tell the difference, Boris.
I'll look into it. In the meantime, please, dust in here.
I only did it 2 days ago.
Then you missed a day.
Boris? 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 Boris?
Morticia?
What's the matter? Were you calling?
It wasn't me. There is nobody here.
It sounded like Mortissa.
Who could that be? The doctor said she wasn't expecting anybody.
Then get rid of them! Now, Boris, now!
What on?
Shigol, what are you doing in here?
Nothing.
Shigol, what are you doing in here?
I just found this on the floor. It belongs to Mortissa. I heard her cry and rush in here, just as Boris came in from the hallway. She was nowhere to be found.
Where is Boris now?
Oh, somebody is at the door. He went to go and answer it. Were you expecting anyone?
Certainly not. Have you seen any sign of... Do you think...
No.
Do you think that he could be responsible for the disappearance of Morticia?
Perhaps.
We have to find him, quickly, before anything else goes wrong. I have the other ready for revival, but I cannot do it while he is wandering about the house. If he gets outside and over the walls, who knows what havoc he may wreak or what public attention he will focus on our project.
I will try my best. Twice now, I have been just moments behind him. But then he'll lose me.
Tricky devil.
There are far too many stairways and passageways and hallways in this old building.
Excuse me, Doctor. The magistrate is here to talk to you. He seems somewhat distressed about what may or may not be going on here.
What do you mean? What did he say? She go to the laboratory, lock the doors, take the stairs.
Yes, master.
He said something about two babbling idiots who he recently apprehended running down the road from here. He was wondering if you were missing anything. They had some silverware on their persons. He said he must speak with you immediately before the matter got out of hand. What should I tell him, Doctor?
Tell him that I am missing nothing and that I will come down to his office first thing in the morning.
First.
Tell him I'm in the middle of an important experiment. Phil, tell him I am unwell and am at rest and am not to be disturbed. Now, Boris!
Yes, Doctor.
Oh, why can these country fools not leave me alone? Why can people not leave me at peace while I discover that which will change their life forever? I am surrounded by fools and heretics. Damn them! Morticia! She's dead!
Oh. Excuse me, Doctor. The magistrate begs me to inform you that since he is here on official business, he has no choice other than to disturb you.
Very well, then. It seems I must see him. Show him in.
I'm sorry to disturb you, Doctor. Especially over what may be a matter of no great importance.
As you can see, Herr von Newdork, I am rather under the weather. I hope your business will be brief and to the point. Perhaps if it could wait until morning. I am sure by then I will have recovered enough to visit you in your office. This would give me chance to discuss elections with you and meet some of the villagers. Perhaps run into your wife, Hildegard, for afternoon tea.
That would be acceptable.
Then that is settled. Thank you so much for being so considerate.
But there is some urgency to the business I'm here to conduct, since you seem directly implicated.
Very well, then. What is it you wish to talk to me about that couldn't wait until morning?
I encountered two men fleeing from this direction as they were crossing the bridge. They were very nervous, but under my direct questioning and my intense scrutiny, they let slip a few morsels of information. About bodies and laboratories. Would you happen to know what they are talking about?
The names of these two would be...
Air France and Air Lib, a motley pair with not a scruple between them.
Seeing as I have nobody under my employment by those names, I could hardly be expected to know anything about them, could I?
Some mention was made of your laboratory. I was wondering if I might take a look.
In the morning, you would be most welcome. I will even share some of my secrets with you about my prize-winning aspidistras. The electrical storm has shorted out my lab generator, and tonight it is in total darkness. You would hardly be able to see anything at all. Shigor, my assistant, is working on it as we speak.
Shigor? I was wondering if I might have a word with him as well.
You're thinking of her brother, Igor.
Ah, yes, I always did get the two mixed up.
And as I said, she is working hard, trying to restore the electricity, and would not be able to come down right now.
Ah, very well then. Perhaps you could send her to see me in the morning. I'm sorry to have disturbed you, Doctor. I do hope you feel better soon.
Boris! Boris! Please show the magistrate to the door, and do not disturb me for the rest of the evening. I am about to return to my bed. Good night, Magistrate von Newdorf.
Good night, Dr. Frankenstein.
Morticia! Shigor! Shigor! Shigor, come and help me with this! Shigor! Good. Now,
What are we to do?
He's got to be here somewhere, Master.
Come up with a plan. Reasonable and rational.
I'm scared.
Shigo, you blithering idiot. There's nothing to be afraid of.
What's another body? It's Hildegard!
Hildegard!
She's alive!
Alive?
And she's fat! What did I do with her?
Forget her! Run, Shigo! Run like you've never run before!
Thank you.